not good rice, farfalon, yam roso. Not the jar, not the tor, no gerano. Then the bell enter on to a riposo.
My black hole dragon is very different to this, so almost the polar opposite of this instinct. This is by no means scientific in the work, but it was a fun illustration, and as long as you remember that it's just that, it is okay. My little cappello galante, quella chioma, quell'aria brillante, quel vermiglio d'onesco color, quel vermiglio d'onesco color.
Look you right, quel panachino, quel cappello, quella chioma, quell'aria brillante. Non più dry, farfalone amoroso, notte giorno di torno gerato, delle belle tabando al riposo. But she said, what did she know to more? Then the belle to run for riposo. But she said, what did she know to more?
Fragueriere, pover bacco, grande stacchi, stretto sacco,
schiumpo in spalla, sciabla a fianco, collo dritto, uso franco, un gran casco, un gran turbante.
Since it by no means based on anything scientific, other than the existence of black holes. But then again, it probably still makes a lot more sense than some of the things featured in the
book.
In my initial sketch, the dragon still has its wings, but it looks a lot cuter without the wings also. It definitely looks quite the opposite of one that is after throwing us into the net. For the illustration itself, I started on out with my white knight watercolour, some acrylic ink and iridescent medium, and I'm trying some new paper. A list of all the materials used can be found in the description below.
Notte giorno di torno gerato, delle belle tabando a riposo.
Ma ci sei
sguardocino d'amor,
delle belle tabando a riposo. And it sure dries up much faster than the cold press I'm using more often. There is one of the sound
machines that I picked up when I went to the water project. It wasn't quite as big as it was.
Comment and subscribe, and I shall see you next week.